Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, I'm going to be showing you how you can buy assets from the Unity Asset Store and import them into SketchUp. Okay, so I've been trying to figure this out for a really, really long time, and I finally figured it out, but it is a little bit tedious. So what I'm gonna do is that in the comment section, I'm gonna pin a comment where I tag different portions of the video, and if there's any links or anything, I'll add them there as well. And just break this down into some steps, so if you get lost at any point, you can always refer to that. But without further ado, here we go. So basically, what you need to do first is download the Unity Hub, so I'll have a link in the comments for that. And then you wanna come to this install section, and you just wanna add an install. So I chose the most recent version, so basically that installed a version of Unity for me. And then you wanna come to projects, go to new, choose 3D. I don't really know anything about Unity other than it's a software. I think you can do some gaming things in it or make games in it. So that's like what the asset store is used for. But when you download something on the asset store, it comes in a Unity pack. And what I was hoping, because of the files structure that was in there, is that I would then be able to just use those like 3D assets. But Unity doesn't allow you to just like have that file. The only way that you can open it is by opening it in a Unity file. Just bear with me as we open the file. Okay, so our file is open. Now what we want to do here is in the asset store, I've already made a purchase on a separate computer and I'm logged in here. You have to log in to use this anyway. So if you click this and go to My Assets, it'll then have this. So then you can hit import and it'll prepare the package and import it into your Unity file. Once that is done, you'll get this little import package screen and you can import whatever you need. For what I'm doing, all I need is the meshes. So I'm just gonna hit M here for the meshes and scroll down, just make sure that I have everything selected. T, I'm not sure what the difference of these are. Brown bear. Yeah, so maybe I'll just keep these as well. So I have these guys, and I don't need any prefabs or anything like that, any scripts. So basically I have these two things, the meshes set, and what I'm gonna do is hit import. While that is importing, you wanna go and check out this page for the Unity Package Unpacker. Basically what's gonna happen is that from Unity, we can export our 3D models, but when we do that, that it's going to be in a Unity package. So we need a third-party software that will then take all the information in that package and export it as raw data for us. So this is what that will do. So again, check the just comments section for a link to download this. After your import is finished, you can see down here that there is a low poly ultimate pack in here. If you click on where it says meshes, just right click on that, you can then export package and it'll list all of these things for you. So you have all of these 3D.fbx files. So you just hit export and then choose your location to save. We're gonna save it to this test area. I already have one saved, but you get the picture. After you've downloaded your Unity package unpacker, what you wanna do is open the zip file. It'll have a setup.exe in there. You just wanna run this, choose your install location, and then navigate to wherever you installed that file. This is where I've installed mine. So I'm just gonna double click this upugui.exe, and it'll open this screen here. Now, if we select input file, and navigate to wherever we saved our package, you can just then click that package, hit open. It's gonna open everything, and then give you some different options for exporting or unpacking. So here you can choose which you wanna bring in and which you don't. And then once you've decided that, you're just gonna hit unpack. It's gonna ask you where you wanna unpack this to. We're gonna choose test here, and then it's gonna unpack all these. Now, if we open SketchUp, what you wanna do is navigate to extensions. You wanna go to the extension warehouse here. In the search bar, you just wanna type FBX. And that's gonna give you a few different options for importing FBX files. So you can see here, there's Fluid Interactive, Transmuter, SimLab. The two that I have tried, so I started out using SimLab. It works great. And then I also was using the Fluid Importer. And then I also was using Fluid Importer Pro. Now, both of these, I looked at them. When you click on this, it says that it costs $99. You can install the trial, which is what I did to test this out. That's a good option just to make sure that everything works. The same thing with SimLab. You can install this. It looks free, but when you actually navigate to import with it, it actually makes you have a license. So you can get a trial license, but that means you have to put in your email. They send you a file, and then you upload the file. So it's a little bit more work, actually, than if you just choose the Fluid Importer. But for now, I would recommend just installing the trial of Fluid Importer, and I'll show you how that works. Once you have the extension installed, what you want to do is go to the Extensions tab, scroll down to Fluid Importer Pro, and there are some different options you can choose in here if you decide that that's something you want to go for. But what you really want to do is go to import, and you can then navigate to your assets, wherever you extracted or unpacked your files to, and then you can select your characters or your 3D models, and then it has you place them in the model. So this is our guy that we brought in. Some of them I found I didn't export everything when I exported the model. So sometimes they have different colors, sometimes they don't, depending on the model itself. So just be aware of that. There may be options to like bring in packed files. I'm not sure how to do that, but for what I'm doing or what I'm using this for, this works out great for me because I just want the 3D information. So hopefully this helped. If you like this video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.